improper integrals. This is your next unit, or you can say your last unit in this paper, Riemann integration in power series. You are all welcome in this class. See, first we will see what is our Riemann integrals called. See, introduction. In the theory of Riemann integration, the range of integration is finite first, and the integrand is bounded in its domain. Means the function is bounded, f is bounded, and the range from A to B is finite. None of them is infinite. It means the symbol integration from A to B f dx, it means that the function f is bounded and R integrable in the finite closed interval AB. Then we shall call this integral from A to B f dx as a proper integral. Now there are three cases when this integral cease to be proper integral. It will be called then improper integral. What are these three cases are? First, when the when the interval AB is finite. See here, closed interval AB is finite, but fx is not bounded in closed interval AB. This is your first condition, and the improper integral of this type is called as improper integral of first kind. Next, when the interval closed interval AB is not finite. Here closed interval is finite, but not now it is not finite. That is when either A or B or both are infinite, but f is bounded in closed interval AB. This type of integral, improper integral, are called improper integral of second kind. Then you have third kind, when neither the interval closed interval AB is finite nor the function f is bounded in closed interval AB. Means we have both this situation, means this interval is not finite and the function is not bounded. We will see cases one by one. In any one of these cases, the integral is called infinite or improper integral. The third case, we shall show that the case third can be reduced to the two cases alpha and beta. See here, it is very easy to see that this can be break into two parts. One is alpha and one is your beta. There are some examples. See, integration 0 to 1 dx by x square. This is your example of an improper integral. Here your limit of integration is finite, but the function 1 by x square is not bounded at x is equal to 0. See here, the integral from 1 to 2, 1 by x minus 2 dx. Here our limit of integration is finite, but the function is not bounded at x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2. So see here, interval is finite here, not finite, but so these are of improper integral of first kind, these two. Third is your improper, third is your integration from 0 to infinity, x by 1 plus x square dx. This is our another example where the limit of integration is not finite. So it is our improper integral of second kind. Now see improper integral of the first kind. In this section, we shall discuss the convergence of these improper integrals in which the range of integration AB is finite. See, improper integral of the first kind, AB is finite, and but the integrand f is not bounded in closed interval AB. This is your improper integral of the first kind. See here, we will see also an example. We may have the following three cases. According as f is unbounded, x is equal to A or x is equal to B, or at some interior point C greater than A less than B. First, see convergence at the left end, means at the left end x equal to A. Firstly, let x is equal to A be the only point in closed interval AB at which f is not bounded. So that according to the assumption made in our earlier article, the integral of fx exists for every epsilon 0 less than epsilon less than B minus A. Why? Because at x is equal to A, f is not bounded. The improper integral from A to B f dx is defined by the limit epsilon tends to 0, integration from A plus epsilon to B fx dx. Why? Because this function f is not bounded at x is equal to A, so A is changed to A plus epsilon, 0 less than epsilon less than B minus A. If this limit exists, See here, if this limit exists, the improper integral, this one, is said to exist, or it is also, in other words, said to converge at A. Otherwise, we will call this integral as divergent. See, this limit must exist for the convergence of this integral or the existence of this integral. So this is our case convergence at the left hand. Now come to second case, convergence at the right hand means at the point B. Let x equal to b be the only point in closed interval AB at which f is not bounded. Then this improper integral is defined by the limit epsilon tends to 0, integration from A to B minus epsilon fs dx, where 0 is less than epsilon, less than B minus A. If now if this limit exists, the improper integral is said to be convergent or said to be existing. Otherwise, we will call it a divergent. See, so we will just need to check that this limit exists for the existence of improper integral or convergence of improper integral at the point x equal to b. Next, convergence at interior points c greater than or less than or equal to less than b. Let x is equal to c be a single point in closed interval ab, that is, this is our a less than c less than b, at which f is not bounded, and f is bounded for all other points. Then we can write as integration from a to b f dx is equal to integration from a to c f dx plus integration from c to b f dx. This we have done in our earlier classes. So since f is not bounded at c, so this is our case. See, both the limits are, limit of integration is finite, so it will be improper integral of first kind. Again, this f is not bounded at c, and c and b both are finite, so this is also improper integral of first kind. Then the improper integral a to b f dx is generally defined by the limit. Is generally defined by the limit integration from a to c minus epsilon fx dx plus integration from c plus epsilon dash to b fx dx. Why? Because at c the function is not bounded. That is why we take here c minus epsilon and here we take c plus epsilon. When epsilon tends to 0 and epsilon dash tends to 0 independently, provided the limit exists. So this is your theory part. Now we will have some examples. See here, example 1. I is equal to integration from 0 to 1 by x square dx. See here, our both limit of integration, they are finite, but the function 1 upon x square is not bounded at x equal to 0. So this is improper integral of the first kind. Hence, the integrand fx equal by is unbounded at x equal to 0, which is a left hand point. So I can be written as limit epsilon tends to 0 integration from 0 plus epsilon to 1 by x square dx. It is equal to limit epsilon tends to 0 integration of 1 upon x square is minus 1 upon x from epsilon to 1. This is equal to limit epsilon tends to 0 1 by epsilon minus 1, and it is tending to your infinity for epsilon tending to 0. This will, the whole thing will tend to infinity, means this integral is not convergent, it is divergent. Therefore, integration from 0 to 1 by x square dx is divergent. So we have checked that whether this limit, this integral exists or not. Since it is divergent, we say that this is not existing. See another example. I is equal to integration from 0 to 1 by root x dx. Here also, your limits of integration 0 and 1, both are finite. But the function 1 upon root x is unbounded at x is equal to 0. So it is the case, improper integral of the first kind. Here, fx is 1 upon root x is unbounded at x is equal to 0. See its solution. This is not a tough topic, you can easily understand it. Here, I is equal to limit epsilon tends to 0, integration from epsilon to 1, x minus 1 by 2 dx. See, 1 upon root x is x to the power minus 1 by 2. It is equal to limit epsilon tends to 0, integration of x to the power minus 1 by 2 is 2 into x to the power 1 by 2, epsilon to 1. This is equal to limit epsilon tends to 0, 2 into 1 minus root epsilon. See here, when you tend epsilon to 0, it will be equal to 2, means it is a finite quantity, so the integral is convergent. Thus, the integral from 0 to 1 and 1 upon root x dx is convergent. So this improper integral is convergent. You can have one more example for your practice. I just show you. I is equal to integration from 0 to 1 dx by root 1 minus x square. Here the limit of integration, they are finite. It means, but the function root 1 minus x square is not bounded at x is equal to 1. So this is your improper integral of first kind. See here, f is unbounded at x is equal to 1. So the integration I can be written as limit epsilon tends to 0, integration from 0 to 1 minus epsilon dx by root 1 minus x square. So it is limit sine inverse x upon minus epsilon y, because 1 upon root 1 minus x square, integration of this one is sine inverse x. So it is sine inverse 1 minus epsilon minus sine inverse 0, sine inverse 0 is 0. So we have this one. Now take epsilon tending to 0. So this will be your sine inverse 1 means pi by 2, as epsilon tending to 0. This pi by 2 is a finite quantity. So this limit is convergent, not divergent. It means the limit exists. Thus the integral, this is convergent. Therefore, this integral is convergent and we get the result. Similarly, there are several other examples. You just practice them. This is all over for today. If you have any query or any difficulty, you just send me messages and the whole lecture will be available on YouTube. So you just see my YouTube lecture and there is a comment section. You better to send your comments in the comment section.